Hi, welcome to my PHP tutorial. These are the instructions how you should use this video. The code for this video can be found here at this URL. Okay, which can be found here at this web page, which is loaded. And we just created the alias, so if you go to localhost and type myphp, okay, you will go to C10 myphp folder. So that will go there. You can use the IP address, it will also go there. You can use that if you change the port. Okay, I did not change the port on this computer, so that won't work. But if you change your port to 8080, you can also go there. Okay, so today we are going to write the first basic HTML document. And as you know, PHP files are actually simple HTML files. So I'm going to force everybody to write one HTML document with me. So I'm going to create a right-click new text document, and I'm going to call this document eg001basic.php, and then I'm going to start typing, okay? So I'm going to call it eg001_basic.php, and then I'm going to open it in NotePy++. And I'm going to start coding. Before I code, you should be able to do a reload and see your EG001 basic here, but obviously there's nothing inside, so you see nothing here. The first HTML document technically is actually a HTML document first. So I'm going to write my HTML. Don't worry, I'm only going to make you guys write this once, and then later we are going to copy and paste. Of course, it will be much easier if we use brackets or Dreamweaver, but to keep it really simple, we are just going to use NotePy++. Okay, I'm not going to explain all this because you guys have done this. In the HTML examples. Okay, very simple HTML document, right? Everybody know how to do this. And before we add PHP, okay, I'm going to put the browser on the left, editor on the right, okay, so that every time you change something, we just reload. Before we even move on, we should validate, make sure our HTML document is correct. Okay, you don't want to make error here before you add PHP. To validate, you have to go to you can go to my file, you have to go to the W3C markup validator. Okay, you cannot do validate by file upload. This one won't work. You have to do validate by direct input because they don't validate PHP file. They only validate HTML file. So validate by direct input, come over here, right click, view page source, copy this, Control C to copy, Come over here, validate by direct input, control V to paste, check. You should see no error message. No errors or warning. If you have error message, you have to fix it. Okay? Alright, so now your HTML document have no problem. You should be, let me close that. You should be able to write some PHP code. So you can add PHP in the head by creating a PHP open tag and a PHP close tag. You can also add PHP in the body. Let me do a P tag first. And then we are going to say what is in between these two P tags are PHP. Okay, so I'm going to create one variable called first name. Okay, you guys need to read the textbook or the provided PowerPoint files for how to declare PHP variables. I'm not going to talk about that in my videos, or else my videos will be super long. Okay, please read the textbook or the you can use the textbook I recommend here. Okay, about the what are the variables and all that. I'm not going to talk about variables in the video, or else YouTube will not be very happy with me. Alright, so I declare two variables. Alright, they are loosely typed, so you don't specify the type. Because they are loosely typed, and you declare text here, so they are actually strings. Okay. Alright, let me print. So now you have Indiana. And then you have Jones, and then you probably, I want them to be, to have a space. You can do that, or I want it to be next line, you can do that, because when you print, you actually output them as HTML tags, HTML code. So if you view source, you actually see BR here, okay? But if you want it to be on the next line, you can actually do BR slash N, right? You will have no effect on what you see here, but you will have what effect that, you will have the effect of what you see in the code if you do a slash N. So if you want a neat code, that's a good practice. All right, now we want to validate this, make sure we have no HTML error. You Control C here, come over here, go back, validate by direct input, Control V, paste. Yeah, no error, good to go. So you have written your first simple HTML document. Oh, sorry, PHP document. Right, you have written your first simple PHP document, which is in a HTML document. All right, that's a good place to stop. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch up with you soon. Bye.